Facts First presents. When soldiers in Vietnam found an old toilet, they transformed it into an insane weapon of war. Before we get into our video, help us out by clicking that like button. Also, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss our future videos. In October 1965, a strange object was dropped from a combat plane. This was the era of the Vietnam War, and the strange object landed somewhere in Vietnam. Now, the object in question was not a bomb or a missile. It was an old toilet, and the fighter pilots who dropped it, they had plans to use it as an insane weapon of war. The plan didn't quite work out, though, for a number of reasons. So why would fighter pilots take the trouble to load an old toilet onto a plane and fly it all the way to Vietnam? I mean, what difference would this particular toilet make to a war effort? Before discussing these points, it is perfectly in order to look at the factors that led to this war. The French colonized present-day Vietnam, and for close to 100 years, the place was under French colonial rule. Vietnam was still under colonial rule when World War II broke out in 1939. The Japanese, who were allies of Nazi Germany, invaded Vietnam. The French colonial masters couldn't protect the Vietnamese from the Japanese onslaught because they were busy fighting the Germans in France and in some of the overseas colonies of France. However, after the defeat of Germany, Japan, and Italy in 1945, the French colonials attempted to seize power of Vietnam again. Well, that didn't go down all that well with the Vietnamese. They were tired of French colonial rule and they wanted a free Vietnam. The Viet Minh was a military resistance movement that was formed in 1943 to fight against the Japanese occupation of Vietnam during World War II. The organization was led by General Vo Nhan Gaiap and later by Ho Chi Minh. The Viet Minh had considerable support from Communist Soviet Union and Communist China. They were tough fighters, and they liberated large swaths of Japanese-occupied Vietnam. After the defeat of the Japanese, Viet Minh leaders seized Hanoi and declared independence from France. However, the French colonials, they wouldn't recognize the independent regime. French forces invaded the country, and that led to the First Indochina War. The First Indochina War lasted from 1946 to 1954. The Vietnamese were united in their desire to drive the French forces out of Vietnam for good. Supported by China and the Soviet Union, the Vietnamese routed the French forces. In 1954, the French were defeated at the Battle of Dien Bien Phu. The French colonials lost, and Vietnam became an independent nation. Ideological differences between North Vietnam and South Vietnam led to another war, and this time American soldiers got involved. How and why did the Americans get involved in a war thousands of miles from home? More to the point, what did the USA stand to gain from getting into this war? During World War II, the Americans and the Russians were united in the war against Nazi Germany. However, after defeating Adolf Hitler's forces, the former collaborators found themselves on opposing sides of the Cold War. The USA was not comfortable with the growing influence of China and the Soviet Union in Asia. Another factor was that the U.S. had allies in the region who needed protection by the U.S. military. In the case of Vietnam, the country was split into two opposing factions. North Vietnam was a communist country supported by China and the Soviet Union. On the other hand, South Vietnam was a capitalist democracy, so America supported it. Initially, the American government provided training, equipment, and logistics to the Southern Vietnamese forces. However, in 1964, North Vietnamese forces attacked two U.S. naval vessels, and that forced the American government to send in ground forces supported by airstrikes into Vietnamese territory. The American involvement in Vietnam was a costly war for the U.S. Clearly, the crushing defeat of the French forces by the Viet Minh was not a fluke. Backed by Soviet and Chinese forces, the Viet Cong gave a good account of themselves in battle. It was after a particularly bloody battle that some Air Force officers decided to transform this old toilet to an insane weapon of war. A wingman and a lieutenant commander, they came up with the plan to smuggle the old toilet into a warplane. Once on board, the plan was to fill the toilet with bombs and drop it on the Viet Cong. Apparently, the plan just didn't quite work. The toilet was filled with bombs and dropped over the Mekong Delta. However, the bombs did not explode. The Vietnam War was bloody and expensive to all parties that took part in it. The unexploded toilet bomb, napalm, and Agent Orange were just some of the terrible realities of this costly war. Subscribe for more!